Hello there, welcome back to our Sydney Proactive studio. Let's go to Perth now to talk to Phil Gallagher. He's the Managing Director of Canyon Resources. Hello, Phil, lovely to see you again. It's been a while.
Hello, Karen, nice to talk to you.
It's always good to see you, and we've got a great update for your company today. You've announced a mineral resource update for the Minim Martap Project in Cameroon. Can you tell us about that and what's happening there?
Yes, Karen. So we've completed our first year of exploration work on the project, and we've upgraded the resource from a previous resource of 550 million tonnes to 892 million tonnes of bauxite. That 892 million tonnes represents only 50% of the available bauxite plateau. So what we've proven is it's a very large resource, but also the grade's very impressive as well. So within that 892 million tonnes, we have 839 million tonnes at 45.2% aluminium oxide and only 2.8% total silica. That's a globally significant resource. And even within that, again, we have a high grade zone of 431 million tonnes at 48.8% aluminium oxide and only 2.5% silica total. So that the resource and the project is substantial. It's a global tier one asset, and thankfully the first year's work has proven that.
Great news, must be very exciting and welcoming news for the company, so well done. Canyon has been reporting some impressive drilling results too from the project over the recent months, including some new areas. So have these all been included in the resource update?
In the last 12 months, we focused on proving the previous work within the previous resource, but then also getting out on new plateaus. As I mentioned, that 890 million tonnes still only represents 50% of the available bauxite plateau on the project area. So yes, we did explore quite a few new plateau, probably about additional 15% on the project area. And yes, they are all included in the current resource. But what it highlights is that as we go out to all our new plateau areas, they're all very high grade. They all maintain the grade. They're all consistent, and they're all very good results. So it gives us confidence that there is well over a billion, maybe 2 billion tonnes of bauxite within the project area, and it's all proving up to be good, high grade, low contaminant bauxite.
What do these results mean for the scale of the project overall?
This is a globally significant bauxite asset. There's no question of it. To have 900 million tonnes effectively that we've released today, we're looking at a 10 million tonne per annum export project. That's 90 years of mining already. Now, that shows that this is a very long-term, multi-decade. And within that, not only do we have 900 million tonnes, 890 million tonnes of bauxite, it's very high grade. And to have the 430 million tonnes of the 48.8% at very low silica, that is some of the highest grade bauxite in the world. And what we also know is within that again, and we're currently investigating it, substantial zones of greater than 50% bauxite, again with very low silica. We know we have a world-class asset in both grade and scale.
Yeah, that's great news. And can you also tell us about progress on other aspects of developing Minim Martap? How is the PFS progressing?
So the first year of work was proving that the bauxite was there. We had it, we needed to explore and drill. We've done that, we've proven it. Now the focus moves on to the PFS. There'll be continuing drilling, we'll continue to upgrade the resource, but the focus is very much now on the infrastructure. So we have a rail component and a port component. The PFS is well underway. We have some global leaders in that area, Asenco and other port consultants. We have local Cameroonians who are experts in the local rail line. We have partnerships with international rail companies that are working with us to come up with the optimal solution for the rail. The key part to this project, now that we've proven the bauxite is there, is proving that we have a solution to export the bauxite out of the country and down to the existing port. We have an existing rail line. We have an existing deep water port that we can utilise.
And what's coming up for the company over the next few months?
So as I mentioned before, the focus is now infrastructure. We have some leading experts working on that. We're working very closely with the Cameroon government, along with continuing drilling. So there'll be, in terms of news flow and information out to the market, there'll be ongoing drilling results, continual resource upgrades. We're having an analysis on the bauxite deposit itself and further work being done on the very high grade plus plus 50% zones, and we'll be announcing that. There'll be continual updates on progress of the PFS, as well as optimising funding solutions and working out funding partners. The pleasing thing is, as our project has come out and we've been able to show the scale and the grade of it, is a level of interest that we're receiving from international funding partners and very credible international bauxite refiners, aluminium producers, who see this as an enormous opportunity to vertically integrate supply. At the moment, we believe that this is the only bauxite deposit of this scale and grade and low contaminant outside of the country of Guinea. Guinea is supplying more than 50% of the global seaborne bauxite, and we believe that we can add a substantial amount to that and be another regional area to maybe de-risk any supply shocks that may come out of that country in the future.
Great update today, Phil. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. Thanks very much, Karen.
Thank you. That's Phil Gallagher from Canyon Resources.